Ray Ray McLeod, he got cleared, so he's limited, at least by the doctors, to practice and everything. Oren Burks limited, Gibson limited, Huff limited, Kittle limited, Mason limited, Jake Moody limited. That's it.
Can you confirm that Nick Bosa has signed?
Yes, I can.
Is he here now?
No, he's going to try to get here today, though. So.
Well, maybe on the practice field, or?
Maybe. I actually was preparing to talk to you guys about how I have nothing to tell you guys. I was 3 minutes late because I told him the news. So, obviously pumped up about it and trying to hit him up after this and figure it out. But I know he's trying to get here as fast as possible.
Are you pumped up and relieved?
For you, like, what were your thoughts as we were getting closer to game one
here? Not good thoughts. But you know, when you feel it's kind of, you don't, you try not to think about it much because it's not really in my control, and you just gotta let the process play itself out. Once it kind of went through the weekend, I just kind of got in my mind that we weren't playing with them. So if I would have gone back and forth, that would have been miserable. So I just decided we weren't. I think our team was ready to not, and that was our mindset this way. And it was a hell of a bonus to just get told that coming in here. So obviously we're excited about it.
Kyle, have you had a chance?
Realistic amount of snaps for Sunday.
How many snaps in the game? I'm just joking. We got to see when he gets here. I know Nick will come in shape. I know he'll be good. It'd be great if he could get in something today. I don't know when he's going to get here or where he's flying from. But you know, we'll be smart with it. That'll be based off of these next 2.5 practices.
You've got plenty of stuff that you guys to take care of, but how much do you get involved? How much did you get involved generally in this specifically? Did you ever just say, hey, guys, let's just get this done? What was your involvement?
I mean, yeah, I always want to get it done, and that's how we feel too. But I didn't get involved in this one at all. I try not to at all. It's, you know, we kind of had an idea it was going to be like this. I thought it would come to fruition sometime last week, and it didn't, which made me nervous, made me kind of move on with it just because I thought I had to. But I mean, we all knew Nick was going to get rewarded like he did. I don't know the exact details of it, but I knew it would be like that eventually. Our organization did, and I think Nick did, and I'm just glad we got it worked out on everyone's side. We love Nick. I think he loves being here, and he's definitely earned this, and he's going to earn it going forward, too.
How did you literally just learn, or did you get the indication that things are getting closer and closer and it could pop any second?
No, literally just learned.
So just what was the first thing you thought of when you heard that news?
Since it was right before I came in here, it was, Corey, why are you wasting my time with these questions? Because you're not going to ask me these questions anymore. So that was it. And now I'm really excited to go out there and have some other thoughts. I'll start talking to coaches and things like that. But once this weekend ended, I kind of had to stop thinking that way. I mean, if you start half in, half out when you don't know, that can really, and that can mess up a lot of the plans and things like that, get people in the wrong position. So we've kind of been just one track, just hoping it would work out, ready for it not to. And the fact it did, obviously everyone knows how it falls through.
Kyle, do you know, you, Chris, Steve, did you guys work on like a plan for what he was going to be doing in Florida in these weeks that he wasn't playing with the team? Is he doing D-line drills? What kinds of things was he doing? Do you know?
Probably the same stuff he does every other day he's down there. Stuff that he knows how to do for D-line. Nick is a smart player in our scheme. It's not the most complicated thing for the D-line, but he's very good at it. So Nick's been on his own completely, and that's why I don't want to answer too much. I got to see when he gets here, but I got to know Nick pretty well, and kind of expect when he gets here to look and act and be in the same spot he's been since the day we met him.
Have you made a corresponding move yet, or does that happen when he puts pen to paper? Or?
No, we haven't.
Is there any question at this point whether he's going to be in the uniform on Sunday?
I mean, there is question because we haven't seen him, but I think you guys know how I'm talking. Have to have a beer belly and be out of shape or something. That's not in Bosa's DNA.
I don't know if you just heard, but do you tell players? What do you do when you hear this?
I'd love to tell guys. They'd be excited. By the time I tell everyone, they'll probably think it's old news, and that's why I don't get that everyone gets stuff a lot faster than that. So they all know, I'm sure, by now, and I know they'll be excited.
Kyle, big picture, you have a group of guys, a veteran Nick Bosa that's been around for a while, a little older, and then you have some young guys kind of emerging. Bosa's like right in the middle of that at 25 years old. How important is it to have somebody like him who can set the standard for maybe kind of that next nucleus, so to speak?
I think it's huge. I feel like that's what we've been trying to do since we've gotten here. We've had some free agents that we've gone in. Paid for, you know. I know we did Hargrave this year, and we went back to Mooney a couple of years ago. most part. You know, we got Trent in a trade and ended up getting that after being here a year. But that's the goal of how you want to do it. You want your players to see that. You hope you get the guys to play the right way and at a certain level, and you can reward them. And, you know, I think it started with, we'll go back to Fred and Devo and Kittle and all those guys. And I think it was, you know, the year after them, right? I think the year after. So I'd like to have one each year.
Have you seen guys following Nick's lead already in terms of, like, you know, eyes fired to that kind of, you know, the work ethic and discipline and all those things?
I think everyone's a product in their environment, so everyone thinks they are based off of people they're around. And then when you get around different people, or you think you're one way or another, and then you see someone like how Fred Warner comes in every day and works, you see how dedicated Bosa is to his craft, not just here, but year around. You see things like that from people you knew before you came. And I think that's just what makes everyone change. I mean, everyone has a certain standard. And then when you see other people at a higher standard who also play at a higher level, it kind of brings everybody up. Shows you what it takes to be this good in this league, to make it this league, and if you have that ability to be in a situation like this, to be great.
What are your guidelines for Moody to decide whether he plays?
Just as long as he doesn't have a setback. He's looking good now, and I feel good about him, and I'd be surprised if he's not there. So we'll keep going at the pace we're at. As long as he doesn't have a setback, we should be all right.
Do you have captains for the season?
Yes, we have Liz Armstead, Brock Purdy, George Kittle, Devo, Fred Warner, and Trent Williams.
Well, being a captain pretty early in his career, like Trey wasn't last season. Did you want to see that? Is it important to you that your starting quarterback's a captain?
It really isn't to me. I thought about this when I became a head coach. I mean, when you think really hard about the captains and stuff, and it'd be cool if there was just one on each, which I kind of like and stuff, but then it becomes a little bit of a popularity contest with the players. I never have to want to get involved and tell them disagree or anything, so I always just get their top guys. I have them all vote for four people. You get the first place, second place, third place, and fourth place vote. I get the top eight, and then you decide off of that. We went 1 through 6, and I think the most we've kept is 7 before, but you know, there's a lot more than 6 guys on our team who could do it, and so that's why it's kind of a thing I try not to be too big of a deal about, because you're going to fence someone on your team.
Do you see him as a leader?
Yeah, I do. I definitely do. It's when you go out and you play like you did last year, that's what it is. I mean, it's hard to be seen as a leader when you haven't been out there before. Guys can think you're a leader. You can act like a leader. The guys don't follow many people who don't produce on the field. And I think that's why you got so many votes this year, because I think they believed in him, probably was one of the leaders last year, not because it's being some vet talking to guys a certain way, just because of how he prepares, that they can count on him. How we handled a number of situations when he got in there.
Take two more guys too, like after he admittedly wasn't what he should have been last year.
I think it says a ton. I think it says how I was happy for Debo he got that. I think he was disappointed he didn't last year. I know he was. And for him to be one of those guys, especially how last year ended a little bit for him, I think it shows how dedicated he's been. You guys have seen it out on the field, you guys have written about it and stuff. And players feel strongly also.
Kyle, one on Pittsburgh's defense. What do they look like on film? What's the traits of a Terrell Austin, Mike Tomlin defense look like?
They play as hard as anyone. Their D-line, their linebackers, their secondary, they all get after it. An extremely physical group. We haven't played them for a number of years, but just watching Hayward, watching Watt, Mika, this guy is not only as talented as it gets, but the mindset they play with, the effort they play with. When you don't see a team for a while, because, you know, not being in the AFC, it's been like three, 4 years since we've gone against them. You don't know where they've come, and it's very obvious why they won 7 out of the last 9 games. It's just watching the team decide to fall and get into their offense, seeing some of the players they have, the way their quarterback's been playing, and the way he played last year at the end of the year. That's been real impressive.
Kyle, you're more of a realist. John Lynch seems a little bit more like he's a little bit more positive. Did that help you throughout this process? You're not a pessimist, you're more a realist. But did that help you through this whole process with Nick Bosa, that he's kind of seems more eternally positive?
I prepared myself from the beginning. So I never was expecting it right away, so which helps me stay more positive. I got a little different these last couple of days, but I haven't been doing it for a while. John has the personality for this stuff. Does a good job with it. I know it's been hard because I know how bad John leads Nick and what I'm here for our team. So I know how much stressed he was feeling that pressure to try to get it done. Not only him, but Prague and Ham. And I could tell when they walked in my door right before I came in here on their face and really just their energy that they had got it done because it was weighing on them a little bit. It was important to get him in here just not for us to just have a better chance to win, but he's the person we know and how big a part of the team he is for us.
Is there a little
how long
mini-
would they have been allowed to stay in the office if they hadn't gotten
it done? If they what?
If they hadn't gotten it done and they came in.
That wouldn't have been very long. They probably want to come down.
Was there a little celebration, mini celebration between the four of you?
There was a couple bro hugs.
Yeah.
Now I told them to go enjoy their day. Now we got to get on to real football.
Did you ever think you'd have to get involved at the last minute?
What's that?
Did you ever think you'd have to get involved in this at the last minute? Or
Not really. I mean, when if I do, it's always just to talk to the player. And I didn't have to do that, so I'm glad.
All right, guys, we got to roll.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks.